A very good morning to all of you. Myself, Shweta Devi, I'm a research scholar from Department of Chemistry, University of Jammu. I'm here for my oral presentation, and the title of my presentation is Hydrothermal Synthesis and Characterization of Terbium Dope Cerium Molybdate. Content of my presentation includes introduction, hydrothermal synthesis of terbium dope cerium molybdate and its characterization, which was done by following techniques. First one is powder X-ray diffraction, second is infrared spectroscopy, third is scanning electron microscopy, and the last is photoluminescence. Introduction. The inorganic nanostructures have received considerable attention to solve environmental problems because of their novel properties, which differ from those of bulk materials. The inorganic nanostructure possesses the advantages of large surface area and high number of surface active sites, which lead to high adsorption efficiency and high removal rate of contaminants. One of the most important families of inorganic materials is metal molybdate, which has attracted increasing attention due to their interesting applications in various fields such as humidity, sensors, scintillator material, magnetic and electrochemical properties, photoluminescence, and microwave application. Different chemical synthetic methods have been employed for preparation of molybdate compounds, including hydrothermal, microwave, precipitation, with different morphologies such as microtubes, disc-like structures, spirals, core shells, and octahedral structures. The photocatalytic activity of different morphology of molybdate-based compound was also studied by some researchers. Photocatalytic process includes chemical steps that produce reactive species, which that is in principle can cause damage to microorganisms. In this present work, we synthesize cerium molybdate at 5 different temperatures, and temperatures are 180 degrees Celsius, 160, 140, 120, and 100 degrees Celsius by a simple hydrothermal method, and study the effect of temperature on morphology of nanostructures. The synthesized nanomaterials characterized by various experimental techniques like XRD, IR, SEM, and their luminescent properties studied by photoluminescence instrument. These are the references which I have taken for my introduction, for the introduction part. Now, the synthesis of terbium dope cerium molybdate. In the synthesis, firstly, we dissolve 0.412 gram of cerium nitrate and terbium chloride in 15 ml distilled water. And separately, we also dissolve 0.2 gram of sodium molybdate also in 15 ml distilled water. Then these two solutions were mixed together with stirring. After that, we add a NaOH solution to achieve the desirable pH, which is, in this case is pH is equals to 9, for the purpose of phase control synthesis. And then finally, the resultant solution, we transfer that in 15 ml Teflon lined stainless autoclave and heated the autoclave at 180 degrees Celsius for 12 hours. After completion of reaction time, the autoclave was allowed to cool naturally, and after that, the product was separated by centrifugation and washed with distilled water followed by ethanol. And finally, the product we dried at 75 degrees Celsius for 12 hours in an oven. Four more samples with the same chemical composition at four different temperatures we are also synthesized in the same flow path. Now, characterization of the terbium dope cerium molybdate nanomaterials. Firstly, we done this by powder X-ray diffraction. And in this, the phase purity of as prepared nanomaterials were determined from X-ray diffraction data collected on D8 X-ray diffractometer at a scanning rate of 12 per minute in the 2 theta range of 10 to 180 degrees Celsius. The major diffraction peaks were observed in the theta range at 28.60 degree, 34.19 degree, 46.97 degree, and 57.92 degree, which corresponds to 112, 200, 204, and 300 crystallographic planes respectively. No extra peaks related to the cerium oxide or molybdenum oxide were observed, which indicated that the high purity of as synthesized cerium molybdate. And from the graph, it is very clear that peaks become sharper with the increasing temperature. Now we've done XRD, IR. The IR spectra of as synthesized product contains falling peaks. Peaks in the region 550 to 900 centimeter assigned to stretching vibrations of molybdenum, oxygen molybdenum. A peak at 920 is due to is due to vibration of molybdate ion, which is present in cerium molybdate, and the peak at 1380 centimeter inverse are due to cerium OH bond. The peak at 3440 and at 1630 are characteristic peaks of OH stretching and bending modes, which are due to absorbed water on the nanostructure surface. Now, SEM images of as synthesized product in the range 100 to 180 degrees temperature without using any surfactant. As it can be seen in the image, with the increasing temperature, a clear shape directing morphology is attained. Irregular trapezoid shape is obtained at 180 degrees Celsius. These are the images of SEM. And then lastly, we done photoluminescence. The emission spectra of terbium doped cerium molybdate obtained by selective excitation at 265 nanometers. In emission spectra of all nanostructures, four typical emission bands we get at that are at 490, 546, 587, and 621 nanometer, which corresponds to the transition 5D427F6, then 5D427F5, then 5D427F4, and 5D427F3 respectively in the visible region. At the end, I want to thank Chitkara University for letting us to represent our work in this conference. So thank you.